For WEAVE, trauma-informed care starts from the second that a person enters the building, informing every layer of your practice. So not as you're informed about trauma, but that informs the way that you do everything, including the way that your environment is, to the way that you interact, to the way that you ask questions on your forms, to ways that you can support clients. It's a whole nother layer to like holistic care. When we talk about trauma-informed care, it's exactly what it says. You're caring for someone or for a community, and it's being informed by the understanding of what trauma is. I guess a common thing that is an outcome of people that have experienced trauma, especially if it's ongoing or really frequently experienced, types of things like neglect and abuse of various types, is that the person who is experiencing that trauma is left in a constant state of fear, expecting something bad to happen. And that has a lot of psychological and physiological impacts on the person for the rest of their lives. And as a social work trained counsellor, it's just common sense, or it's just, I don't know, embedded into our brains that you always work from a client-centred perspective. The client is always the expert of their lives, not you. You're there to help guide them through the journey to healing or through the journey of whatever it is for them. It's not about telling them what to do or labelling as something.
We feel very strongly about being flexible and meeting the needs of the client. Every client is different. Every client comes to you with a unique perspective on life, with unique experiences, unique goals, unique needs. So it's really important that we listen to that and respect that. It's not a one size fits all.
We switch the question around. We don't ask what is wrong with you. We ask what has happened to you in your life and how can we support you. It's essential to look at that person as a whole human being, not just as the presenting behaviours that you see before you when they come in to sit, you know, to your office or to sit in the chair to have counselling.
Before I came in here, like I didn't really know where my life was going, to tell you the truth. But since I met Ainsley and she's been my caseworker, you know, she kind of guided the way, and yeah, I reckon my future looks brighter.
I think one of the biggest challenges of working from a trauma-informed perspective is actually working alongside so many organisations that aren't working from that same perspective. If we could all work from this common ground, I think that people would just have so much more productive work going on and so much more success in their recovery.
At the end of the day, most of the work is done within the relationship that you build. So if we have a good relationship with our community, with the individuals that we're working with, we will see healing, you know, we will see mental health being able to be managed, we will see suicide rates drop, we will see drug and alcohol problems not needed in a person's life anymore because they have an understanding of their mental health and their trauma.